God is good
all the time.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. Finding a job has been very, very difficult for a college graduate recently in Korea. But however, for Handong students, Handong graduates, as long as they get past the first step, the paper application, their interview acceptance rate is much higher than any other university in Korea. So it's a good news, isn't it? It's a good news. Amen? Yeah, great news. Of course, the first question you get when you sit down in the interview is, give us 3-minute introduction of yourself. That's the first question you get. And then our student at Handong, we are very used to do it, right? At the first team meetings, in small group meetings, and club meetings, you always introduce yourself. So how would you do that? Don't you always include your major and class years and your hometown or even your home countries? However, if your interviewer said to introduce yourself without mentioning your major, without mentioning your class year or hometown, what would you say? Why don't you do it now? Practice, okay? Introduce yourself to the person next to you. As without mentioning your class years, or hometown. Go ahead, I'll give you time. If you come up with one perfect, one sentence self-introduction, next person you hear, then you recommend and come front and introduce his friend's introduction. Is there anyone who can introduce yourself or the person next to you with one sentence? Is there anyone who can introduce yourself in one sentence? I have a gift for you. Is there anyone? You want to introduce? Come on, come over. Or you? Or you? Okay, come on.
Okay, his bread is a servant
of God. Oh, that's good. Oh, all right, give a big hands. Servant of God. That's what we want to do. Here is a gift for you. So, Hyoam Chapel with the bookmark here. Oh. Thank you. Yeah. Isn't it hard? Yeah. My challenge to you today is, how can we come up with a perfect one-sentence self-introduction? It's very hard to come up with one sentence that has your life's dream and philosophy and worldview in all in one. Today, I want to show you how to do it through one example of one person. That person was not Roman, but wrote the book of Romans in the Bible. No one has influenced Christianity as much as this man has, except Jesus Christ, of course. Who is he? Paul. Yeah, Paul. He wanted to go to Rome, but had not been able to go there yet. Since he was writing to people that he had never even met before, he had to introduce himself at the beginning of the letter. That one sentence he wrote to introduce himself was a perfect introduction. Let's read that verse 1 again here. Let's begin. 시작. Paul, a servant of Christ Jesus, called to be an apostle and set apart for the gospel of God. Yes. The first verse starts with Paul, right? And servant of Christ Jesus. And followed by like another two phrases, like servant of Christ Jesus, and called to be an apostle, and third, set apart for the gospel of God. For better understanding of this meaning, I suggest to read this verse in Greek, okay? How about reading this verse in Greek, this time only for the freshmen? Here's the bottom, okay? Paulos, Doulos, okay. I suppose it's a little difficult for the freshman at this moment. Maybe by the time you become a senior, you will be able to read it, okay? Seniors are no problem, okay? Paul introduced, Paul introduced himself as a Paulos, Doulos. First the word is Paulos, next one is Doulos. Then there's Yesu, Christus, Christu, yeah, Christu, Cletus, Apostolos, well, something like that, okay? The first word is Paulos, okay? It's his name, Paulos, okay? The second word is Doulos, the meaning slave rather than servant, as you see in the dictionary here. Doulos. Doulos, a slave. Okay? At the end, it says a servant. The first meaning of doulos is slave. But somehow the English translation uses servant. But other places, other language version has slave. Also, some part of the Romans, they use slaves a lot. But somehow, in this place, somehow they have translated as a servant. So back then, it was the lowest position you could ever have in society. It was said that slaves were equal in value to your donkey. And the only difference was that the one could talk. But donkey couldn't talk, okay? The first word Paul used to describe himself was doulos, slave. Doulos is a possession of his master. He must completely obey his master. If his master says to go and jump off a bridge, he must go and jump off the bridge. Doulos lives and breathes for his master. He exists for his master. He's not a person, legally. He's not a person, but a possession. Yet, even knowing this, Paul chose to use the word doulos in his self-introduction. The student of most respected scholar of Gamaliel had become a slave of Jesus. But this wasn't Paul's way of being humble. This was not an expression of his humbleness or humility. In many other parts of the Bible, it is clear that Paul's identity was to be a slave of Jesus. Being the slave of Jesus was his philosophy, his lifestyle, life code, and his way. Of course, as Christians, we must be Jesus' disciples. We must be Jesus' bride, or his brothers, and his friend. This is all true and good. But more than any of those, we must be Jesus' slave. No Christian can claim to be Jesus' disciple, bride, brother, and friend without claiming to be his slave as well. When legendary Paul introduced himself as a slave, his Roman readers were probably very surprised, because at the time, the population of Rome was like 60 million people there. Among the 60 million, 10 to 20 million of them were slaves. And most of the Roman church members were slaves. Both Paul and his readers were fully aware of what it meant to be a slave. When Paul called himself a slave, he was basically saying, hey, dear Roman church members, are you living as a slave? I am also a slave, like you. But my master is Jesus Christ. By calling himself a slave of Jesus Christ, Paul's readers knew exactly where he was coming from. And Paul was able to capture their attention, putting that first word, doulos, in his letter. Paulos doulos. So he gets all the attention from the reader. At the same time, the reader, Roman church members, can feel Paul's passion for the gospel through this one keyword, doulos, or Paul's self-introduction. The second part of the Paul's introduction was called to be an apostle. At the time, the title of apostle represented the highest authority. After Jesus returned to the heaven, apostles took up Jesus' authority and led the church, early church. It was a position of that highest power and authority. Jesus' 12 disciples were called the apostles, and there were only very few others. Apostle means one who is sent out. Okay? In Greek, apostolos means messenger sent with the king's full power. Nowadays, it would be same as like ambassador. We can understand the word apostle clearly through John 17, 18 and John 20, 21. Let's read together. As you sent me into the world, I sent them into the world. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you. Jesus himself was commissioned by God. Jesus came to this earth as a man and at the same time as God's ambassador. A messenger's authority changes depending on who sent him. For example, ambassador's power directly correlate to how strong their home country is. Christians are ambassadors to this world. And Jesus, who has all authority on heaven and earth, sent us into the world. Therefore, all Christians are Christ's ambassador and the ambassadors of God's kingdom. Paul introduced himself as doulos Jesu Christu first. Next, he introduced himself as an apostle. Cletus apostle, the fourth word, the second yellow word is apostolos. But how did he become an apostle? What other word did he use to introduce himself as an apostle? First one was doulos, second one is apostolos. What's the word that he explained he is apostle with the extra word? That's called, in Greek, this kletos. In English, it's a called. It's called. It's a called. It is a very important word. The best evidence you can give that you are apostle is that God called you to be an apostle. You are a messenger. God is authority that is sending you. This gives you great power and authority from God. An important keyword of your life is what you are called for. I believe that God called all of you to Hangdong. I also believe that God has more plans for you. It's not just finished by calling. So in the chapel, you go to the chapel, there's a three word, called, then cultivate, and then commissioned. I hope God keep calling you to be cultivated and keep calling you to be commissioned. So the part of Paul's self-introduction was set apart for the gospel of God. Dear my student and professors, why do you think you have been called to Hangdong? God must have a definite plan for each one of you. God must have definite plan for you, each one of you. But do you know what that plan is? Paul knew the purpose of God's calling for him, and Paul made it his life's purpose. What did Paul say his life purpose was in verse 1? Look at the verse 1. And what did Paul say his life's purpose was in verse 1? For the gospel of God. For the gospel of God. That was his purpose. I'll ask you again. Why was he called as a slave of Christ Jesus? Answer is, for the gospel of God. Why was Paul called to be an apostle? Answer is, let's say all together, for the gospel of God. What was Paul set apart? For the gospel of God. We are not used to it, okay? So let me repeat this question again. So I suggest then you read the answer, okay? God is good? Like this, okay? Okay. Why was Paul called to be an apostle? Amen. And what was Paul set apart for? For the gospel of God. Yeah, for the gospel of God, how amazing and exciting is that vision. For the gospel of God, how fulfilling as life's purpose. When you introduce yourself, can you include for the gospel of God in your one sentence introduction? Paul talks about this gospel of God in Romans 1:15 and 16. It is the power of God for the salvation of everyone who believes. Then who could there be ashamed of? Therefore, with all my strength, I will preach the gospel to those in Rome and Spain and to the end of the earth. Shall we shout it again? Shall we shout it again? Amen. God is good? All the time. Okay. Let's read verse 1 again. Yeah. Not in Greek part, just the top part, okay. Paul, a servant of Christ Jesus, called to be an apostle and set apart for the gospel of God. Amen. Now, do you think all of you can come up with one perfect self-introduction in one sentence? Can you? Paul chose some impressive and awesome word for his self-introduction, like this. Servant, Christ, Jesus, called, apostle, set apart, gospel, God. This incredible word. These words are called keyword. This revolutionary word that Paul himself experienced firsthand. Keyword, it is such an interesting word, keyword. Think about it. If you want to drive a car, open a safe, you need your key. If you lose the key to your apartment, you are in trouble. Cars, safes, apartment, they all have keys to open. But writing also has a key. It is called keyword. Instead of key, it is called keyword. When you have writings, when you write a paper along with an abstract, you have to list your keyword, right? So when people first come across your paper, they can just read your abstract or keyword. Then they know what you are coming from, where your paper is about. Bible has such a keyword, also does the Romans. So what would the keyword of the Bible be? God, Jesus, Holy Spirit, creation, fall, salvation, love, cross, law, faith, etc. What would the keyword of Romans be? Of course, all many keywords in the Bible, including gospel, salvation, sin, righteousness. But I would like to add keyword slave in Romans. Let's imagine Paul for a moment, okay? He's an apostle, but he doesn't identify himself as an apostle at the first, right? He presents, identify himself as a slave, Paulus doulos, right? Paulos doulos. He's first identified himself as a slave. Once we understand that Paul saw himself first as a slave, we can understand the book of Romans. That's called keyword. We can understand Paul's life because a slave was Paul's keyword. Slave is the keyword in Romans. It is a keyword of Paul's life as well. Paul put the keyword of his life in one sentence. Romans 1:1 has the keyword to the book of Romans and to Paul's life. Paul's keyword became his perfect self-introduction. Dear Handong student, what's your keyword? What are your keywords? If you look at successful people, they had some kind of their own keyword. Some say that your keyword is your motto, or philosophy, or purpose, or vision. George Mueller, you know him, right? George Mueller's keywords were prayer and orphans. Mother Teresa's keyword was what? Mercy. How about Abraham Lincoln or William Wilberforce in England? Their keyword was slavery. Liberate slave. Korean celebrity, Cha In-pyo, you know Cha In-pyo, right? Yeah? What's his keyword? Recently, he came over Handong a couple of times. His keyword nowadays, North Korea. Yeah? I also found the keyword, my keyword for my life, long time ago in Romans. Let me introduce that keyword. Let's read together. 시작. I am debtor both to the Greeks and to the barbarians, both to the wise and to the unwise. Yeah, I found the debtor as my keyword. Ever since then, my email address, signature I put at the end of the email, okay, has had debtor in it. I debtor, handong.edu, I debtor, gmail.com. I also have another email, I am debtor, at handong.edu, I am debtor, at gmail.com. I debtor. They become my keyword for my life. It is important that each of us find the keyword to drive your life. Purpose-driven life starts with finding the keyword of your life. Many people have found their keyword in Romans or in the Bible. I hope each one of you find a few keywords that will define and identify your life. When you do that, you will naturally have perfect one-sentence self-introduction. Many people who found their life keyword in Romans and changed their own lives and also changed their life. Like 4 years of college at Handong are so important. Your 4 years of college are so important. They are the keys. They are keys to your life. With those keys, you will open the doors to the rest of your life. Let me repeat. With those keys, you will open the doors to the rest of your life. You graduate, you go to the world. You need a key to open that world. 4 years of you spend here will drive your life in the near future. I hope that through your 4 years at Handong, you prepare your key to the treasure chest filled with God's glory. What kind of life do you want to live? What will drive your life? What kind of key will you hold when you graduate this school? Believe it or not, that key will drive your life. Believe it or not, that key will drive your life. Dear Handong student, Paul was the last person likely to believe in Jesus. Yet he was the one called to be an apostle to the Gentiles. I know there are non-believers here at Handong. Wait for God. Long for God. Desire for God. God even called Paul, who arrested and killed Christians for living. I believe God will call and cultivate anyone here at Handong. Even here. In fact, if God has brought you to Handong, He has already called you. It's your turn to answer. One student may ask a question. Hey, Chaplain Kim, I didn't come to Handong because I wanted to. I came to Handong because my mom forced me to go. I came to Handong because I failed my entrance exam. 그렇다고 해서 여기 있는 뭐 나쁜 대학은 아닙니다. It's a good school, though. Okay. Whether you came to Handong voluntarily or involuntarily, if you are here, you are here because God called you here. Do you believe that? Amen. There is no way any one of you could have come here without God's providence. There are no accidents in God's plan, but only His providence. Did Paul voluntarily become the apostle? No, no way. He would have had to wait another. We would have had to wait another 2,000 years for Paul to voluntarily become an apostle. If we answer God's calling, God's plan will proceed. If we don't answer God's calling, God's plan won't happen. If you turn your dorm room into a game room 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, it will probably be a lot of fun, right? Some of you did, right? However, the fun will be short, but the pain will be long, okay? The fun will be short, and the pain will be long. I make it rhythm here. Because you won't be making the key to drive your life in college. Instead, you're collecting a few game items, game weapons, game treasures, okay? That will ruin your life. Believe it or not, each one of us at Namsongni, this address of this school is Namsongni 3번지. Let's repeat again. Namsongni 3번지. 3 district, 3rd district. Believe it or not, each one of us at Namsongni, because God called us. You are not here because there is no college in your hometown, or in your country, or in Seoul. You are not here because there are no other places to play games. You are not here to make campus couple, nor CC as your keyword either. You are all here because God called you. Called us, and we answered His calling, which brought us to Namsongni. Answering His calling is the key word of your life. It is your purpose and your vision, dear Handong student. So the question remains, how can we find our life's key word? Before we answer that question, I will give you one more question here. Okay, one more question. If we answer this correctly, I can give you some gift. I still have some, not cash, but have some gift here. Here. Okay. My question is, what do these people have in common? What's common in these people? At least two. Answer two. Believe. Okay, believers. And one more, please. Slaves? Slaves of Christ. Oh, come on. So you have a choice. I have two kinds of sticker here. One is this and one is this. What's your name?
My name is Permet and I'm from Kyrgyzstan.
Okay, Kyrgyzstan. Okay, your choice. Both. Okay. Yeah, these people are old men, right? Died. It's a common thing. And all Christians, right? All men. Men. What's in common? Yeah, all true. They're Christians, foreigners. No Korean there. Old men. Yeah, all men. Okay. Also, the common thing for these people are Romans changed this man's lives. Romans changed their life. The book of Romans changed their lives. This man, in turn, changed the world, right? Augustine, Martin Luther, John Wesley, Uchimura Kanjo, Japanese. Yeah. They are all history makers, but their life was changed by Romans, the book of Romans. I believe that most valuable book or books in the world is the Bible. Also, I believe that most valuable book or books in the Bible is the book of Romans. It is not an exaggeration to say that Romans is the book that influenced Christianity most. The book of Romans changed these people, and they changed the history. Dear Handong student, so then, how can we find our life's keyword? They found their keyword in the Romans, but how we can find? I would like to propose two ways. First, study the book of Romans, of course. Paul wrote Romans with a specific purpose in mind so that these readers of Rome could correctly understand the gospel. The only letter, Paul wrote many, many letters, but this is the only letter that Paul wrote to a church that he had not started. Yeah, this is the only letter that to the person or church he hadn't started, haven't went, gone. The only letter. So he put the every effort with the Holy Spirit to preach the gospel. But maybe because he had not started the church himself, Roman is the complete explanation of core of the gospel. Thus, if you study Romans, you can understand the gospel properly and well. Second way to find your life's keyword is to read and meditate on Romans. Uchimura Kanjo, Japanese scholar, Christian scholar, said, "You cannot understand Christianity without understanding Romans." I would like to add that without reading Romans, you cannot find your life's keyword. Then you cannot write your perfect one-sentence self-introduction either, neither. Without reading Romans, you cannot change the world. Would you read, please? 시작. Without reading Romans, you cannot find your life's keyword. Without reading Romans, you cannot change the world. The book of Romans is made up of 16 chapters. If you read it out loud, you can read it in 1 hour. So if you read fast, you can finish it like 35 minutes or 40 minutes. Just look for one keyword every time you read it through. If you promise to read Romans once a week in this semester, rest of the semester, we can read 10 times easily. Just look for one keyword every time you read once through, okay? You don't have to find a lot. Paul did it with 10 words or less, 9 words. He did his perfect one-sentence introduction. If you want to change your life, don't you think you can devote 1 hour a week? Why don't you join campus-wide campaign of reading the book of Romans? Even there are some students gathering to read Romans on Sunday evening. Some of the Korean students already started. Before you read, you may just pray that, God, I'm about to read the Romans. Please give me a keyword to drive my life. Show me the keyword that I can hold on to change the world. Dear student of Handong, I challenge you to read Romans 10 times and find the 10 keywords. Use this semester to prepare the key. Use this semester to prepare the key to open your life and the key to drive the rest of your life. Then you will have no problem with coming up with your perfect one sentence self-introduction. If you find the 10 keywords, you will have found your life's purpose. Are you looking for your life's purpose? Read Romans. If you can find the 10 keywords, you will have found your life's purpose. Then your life will change. The power and passion of gospel will awaken and heal your life. Then you will be able to join the ranks of the history makers. In order to help you, we have provided you with bookmarks of Romans. You may write the date each time. You may write a date each time when you read. We have 10 lines of the date line here. And you can put your date each time you read the book completely. And also we have some space here in the left side. So you can put your keyword, one keyword, once you read completely, once the Romans. We have those bookmarks in front. Okay. You may pick it up. Not only will your life will be changed, you will have a souvenir to remember it for your life. I pray that Romans would become your most favorite book of the Bible. I pray that you, each one of you, find your life's keyword in Romans or in the Bible. I pray that all of us, each one of us at Handong would be called and cultivated and commissioned for the gospel of God. 다시 한번, let's do it again. For the gospel of God in Jesus' name. Let's pray.